ever since I was 17. Just like petty thefts and just burglary, assaults, stuff like that. I don't have a whole lot of, I mean, my family support me and stuff like that, but when it comes to my, like, my talent with art, it's never, I've never really done much with it. I mean, other than the tattooing, and that's a money thing. But as far as, like, there's a lot of negativity that goes with tattooing, especially if you're running a parlor out of your home. You know, people want to pay with other things other than cash, and it's kind of hard to turn down some things, especially, you know, when you're drinking and like that. And it's just, I don't know, I've been trying to get out of it for a long time. The money keeps you in it, but I'm not gonna tattoo when I get out. I'm getting away from the tattooing, staying away from it completely. The commanders encouraged me to do something with the art in this form, and that's exactly what I'm gonna do.
And there's a reason that these people are making the choices they're making that land them here. We're not trying to solve all their problems, but if we can restore some humanity and instill some confidence and have these folks tap into their natural abilities, well, perhaps when they get out of here, that'll translate into them doing something more positive.
I've never been encouraged by a man like that, by people like that, and it's like, Maybe it'll work for me. I've sat in jails, I've sat in cells before and been so depressed that I contemplated suicide, you know, seriously, like, consider it. And I kind of like to think that in times like that, there is an angel leaning on me, you know what I mean? Keeping me from those horrible thoughts or from doing something so terrible, you know, destroying myself and taking me away from my children and my family, ultimately. There is a hope, you know, one day you are gonna go home and your family's still gonna be there. They're gonna love you all the way through it. You just gotta get through this. And the thing is just sitting in a cell, waiting for your turn to go home ain't enough. If that's all you're doing, you're gonna be back. You're coming back.
They've made some horrible choices, and they're paying their debts. But as far as we're concerned, they're still human beings. And, it's a management tool for us as well. We've learned over the years that if you treat folks like human beings, surprisingly, that's what they act like. And so we try and live by that adage. And, you know, it doesn't take anything away from us to show some compassion and some humanity and still, you know, dole out the law and justice and be fair and equitable. I think the two can go together.
You know, the main theme right there, break the chains that bind you. You know, everybody's got to break their habits, break the bad habits they have. Break addiction to drugs, you know, break their, some of them had attitudes and they gotta, you know, figure out how to break that so they could get out and be a better person. So that's why I figured maybe. And that right there, I drew up. It took me 20 minutes. The day that was coming down here, I drew that up in 20 minutes and showed Miss Fighting if she wanted that. And that ended up being on a wall instead of something else. I've always been, I live the street life, and I've always got bad influences, bad, you know, remarks from people. And me coming in here, getting feedback from, you know, the top people, they're saying that you're real good at what you do, and it made me feel good because I never had that before in my life. I've always been put down, and hearing that from everybody makes me feel real good, and I want to keep going.
Unfortunately, you know, life inside the facility for some of these people is better than it has ever been outside, and that's a real shame. Again, if whatever we can do, you know, to help smooth the transition, because here's the thing, these folks live in all of our communities. You know, they're our neighbors. They shop where we shop. They dine where we dine. Our jail is not any different than any other. You know what it is? It's a microcosm of society at large. There are all kinds of people inside that facility. We've had doctors in there. We've had lawyers. We've had other professionals. You know, they're not all what society at large would consider the dregs. And so I can't stress it enough. Whatever we can do to help ensure that they don't come back, to me is well worth it. And not only that, you know, we have a fiduciary responsibility to the taxpayer. I mean, this place is run with public dollars. And if we can reduce recidivism by a small percentage, you know, it saves a lot of money on the back end. You know, we booked in 15,000 inmates last year. And if we cut that number by 30%, which would be 4,500 inmates, it's a lofty goal. And it'll take time to get there. Those aren't results that you realize in the short term. But, you know, at $100 a day to house these folks, you know, that's a savings of $450,000 a year. I hope it is long-lasting, and it has already filled the two artists with tremendous pride. You know, they weren't behavior problems before, but their attitudes are a lot better since they started working on this project. Their outlook on life is a little bit different already. Already they're talking about long-term goals for when they get out of here, which is something that is rare. We don't often see or hear inmates talk about some long-term goals that they want to accomplish. You know, for me, that's half the battle. You know, you need to have a plan first so that you can figure out how to execute it. And I think that's where a lot of people get stuck. They just kind of wander aimlessly, and one bad choice leads to another, and you have that snowball effect.
I'm ready. I'm ready to go home. I want to go home. I don't ever want to have to step back in a place like this again. And I know that as much as they like me, they don't want to see me again either. You know what I mean? And that's what I think's neat. The commander of this jail is more interested in getting your head screwed back on the right way, putting you in the right direction, kicking you out the door, rather than to just throw you away.